Okay, this is Martin. He is the owner of the Ioniq. As I'm discussing with him about, you said you pick up people at the airport, right?
Yeah, I work at the airport sometime. I'm a contractor, so I work at the airport.
So do they have a dedicated charger for you, so you charge at the airport? Yes, you have,
yes,
right?
They do, yeah. They have chargers in the parquet. They have a charger at the Alt Hotel.
Yes, the Alt Hotel one. Actually, I asked them what I really wish. If I have an electric car, then what I will do, I will always, I will help more people to drive them free to the airport.
Okay.
And pick them up free from the airport. And what I can do is, after I drive there, I ask the front desk, they say, sure, you can. So I can plug my car in for probably like 20-30 minutes. So juice up a little bit, and then go into the terminal to pick up someone. And as they come out, I grab them, and grab their luggage, put it into my car, and unplug, and drive home. So naturally, I will use I'm have the free range.
Yeah, that's it.
For at least half of the way, right?
Yeah. Of course, like the Alt Hotel, like they've been very good.
Yeah.
If you go pick up,
very very friendly.
Oh yeah. If you go to pick up somebody, you just park there, charge it up while you waiting for the flight.
Yep.
Sometimes they're delayed, right? So you can be there for an hour or two.
No. You see, that's a term for me. I use an app called Flight Radar.
Oh, okay.
Flight Radar 24. So what I have is Flight Radar 24. So it shows all the aircrafts around us in real time.
Okay, so you know if it's delayed or not. Yeah.
So I know clearly whether
that's
it's delayed
good,
or not. And only thing is probably about the 10-20 minutes I'm sitting in the airport.
Yeah.
If I have an EV, I can juice it up.
Yeah, that's right.
And sadly, sometimes that spot will be iced by ice cars.
Yeah, that's right.
Which is extremely, extremely uncomfortable for
me
as an EV lover. But to be honest, most of them, actually, I talk to them. I say, if I'm here, there, I saw a fossil car sitting there with the driver inside, I will tell them, this is designed for EV owners.
Yeah.
You'd better do not park there. Then they will know. They probably will wait for another 5 minutes and they drive away.
Yeah, they should probably just put a sign for EV only.
Yeah.
There's no sign there, but. Yeah.
But if people only park for like 20-30 minutes, but there's no people charging there, it's fine. I think that spot will be more like 30 minutes limited general parking. Like the Tesla store, some of them, they have a 30 minutes limited general parking.
Yeah.
Oh, and another thing, I know the problem of this is, of the problem of this car is it uses CCS. So we don't have a lot of CCS chargers here before.
Well, here, like,
so how do you deal with it?
All the fast chargers in Nova Scotia, in Brunswick and Quebec.
Yeah.
And I never been to Ontario, but those are all the same machines.
Yeah.
They do have the Shadow and CCS.
Yeah. So nowadays we have all these CCS around the Nova Scotia thing, thanks to Nova Scotia Power and Flow. So now we have everything.
Yeah. Well, I've been using them a lot, and
I'm planning, like, one day if I pay a visit to Montreal, I will rent a car there, and the car rental company I will choose is definitely Evoto.
Oh yeah.
They rent all the EVs and they give you free lectures.
So, Hanan, you've had this now for what, 4 months now?
May, so.
Yeah, May, June, July, August. Yeah, so at least
four months.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think so far, man?
So, it's nice.
Yeah?
Drive nice. Yeah. I mean, I've done a few trips, but.
Short trips?
Yeah. Bridge.
Well, what about do you use this as a daily commuter?
Yes,
what?
Yeah.
How is
my daily driver?
Yeah. Well, how many kilometers do you put on a day?
Depends. It's less. It's probably 100.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's quite a lot.
Yeah, it's quite a lot.
I drive 20 every day. No,
well,
not even every day.
I'm in Porter's Lake, and sometime I go to the airports, and then I go to back to pick up my kids.
Yeah.
And then we have soccer at night.
Yep.
And
okay. And so you just, how often do you charge your car?
I charge it mostly at the office.
Okay.
Well, part of it. So it doesn't cost me much.
No way. Okay. That's amazing.
Free
electricity.
And is that a regular plug? Is that a 120?
Yeah. No, that's a 240.
240?
Yeah.
Does it support 120 though?
Yeah, it does. Yeah.
Yeah.
It just takes 22 hours to charge.
Yeah. You can show him the charge port. Okay, can I take a look at the charge port?
Sure.
Because I know some of them are, like, we are in North America.
Okay.
So I'm thinking about whether it is a, oh yeah, it's a CCS.
Yeah, this one first.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it's a CCS plug. It's a little bit different than the European version, so.
Yeah.
But
yeah, CCS. And the, well, that's the J1227.
J1772.
Oh, the other one first here.
Okay, this one first. Oh, and this one on the top.
It's for the fast charger, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and it has a light inside, so you can see the...
Yeah, there's
you can see it during night.
And as soon as you approach the car, the LED comes on here. Because I have the key in my pocket.
Yep.
No, it's, okay. It's cool, but you don't see it.
Yep. This is Kurt, he is the owner of the Kia Soul. Yes, another car. In fact, the name Soul is one of my best friend's nickname. His big nickname is Soul.
Oh, yeah?
And one of the nicknames he used in the game to give his name character is called Inscribable Red Soul. So I say, you should get a Soul EV.
Oh, yeah.
Which is silent, no sound, and really like a Soul.
I like to say I have an electric Soul.
Yes. You know?
It sounds cooler, it sounds retro.
Yeah. So is that the aero wheels as well? So they put on the caps to increase the aerodynamics?
It's the only wheels. I mean, it's not like you have other options.
Yep.
But these are the only wheels.
Yes.
You can tell they're very similar to these ones too.
Yes.
I mean, Hyundai and Kia, right? You know, they're the same company. Hyundai owns Kia.
And I do believe they use the same software in their center console.
Exact same.
Yes. And newly, the Honda comes out with the Hyundai comes out with the Hyundai Kona.
Oh, the Kona, yeah, that looks cool.
So you said you live in Potter's Lake.
Yeah.
So how long is your commute every day? 50
all way. 50? It's about 45 to 50 kilometers one way.
Okay.
So it's about 100.
Take a look at your car. So how about how is the what's the range on the Soul though?
Very similar to this one.
Uh-huh.
About 175 kilometers.
Yeah. Yeah. Although it's more boxy.
Yeah.
This
one, you know what? They almost have the same engine, almost the same battery.
Yeah.
This one gets.
It does not have an engine. It has a motor.
That's right. It's a motor.
Yeah.
The
battery is slightly larger, I think, probably.
This one's a 27 kilowatt hour.
Oh, okay.
This one's 32. 28.
Okay. Really?
Sure. But this one makes a little bit more mileage because of its
aerodynamic. Yes.
Especially highway.
Yeah.
But
so you are more boxy,
yes.
So you can fit more stuff in.
Yeah. I love the glass roof on this one.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorites.
Oh yeah, the glass roof and sunroof.
Glass roof.
Yeah. Oh, you have the wood trim.
Yeah.
Didn't
I'm not
see.
Sure if it's legit or if it's simulated, but
I'm more like the carbon fiber.
I saw that. I don't like it. It just looks like a bunch of crosses. It's just weird to me.
I think it looks futuristic. Yeah.
I think the rest of the car does the futuristic. This actually ties it to old school.
Yeah. And you have a little bit aggressive driving just now. Do you? I saw
that's actually normal for highway.
Oh, okay.
It's because I go up to speed and then I have to coast down.
Oh yes,
speed.
You ramp up the speed and ramp down the speed.
Yeah. I mean, if you look on the long range one, it shows out the same.
Yeah.
Overall.
Yes. And you can pause the navigation now.
Well, normally the nav defaults to top, and I don't like that because I like my camera up top.
Ah. I'm more like the Model 3's horizontal screen.
Well, there's ones they haven't released the UI, so you can rearrange it however you want. It's more or less stock.
Yeah.
So eventually, that's probably what they're going to do, but they haven't yet.
Oh, and yes, this is a cup holder at the back.
Yep. I needed somewhere to put that because I keep it in the front, it's going to overheat.
Really? I think the front. Oh.
Because my backpack is black, and that's what I had that stuck in, so it was just overheating my water.
And this is a...
Just a cup holder.
I have these coupons as well at home.
Yeah, they just came in this yesterday, so I might use some of them.
Yep.
I'll probably just throw most of them out eventually.
And can this one open? Or nope?
Nope. Down here and here.
Yes. And you have J1772 as well. Same thing.
I keep it there just because it's easier.
Yes, easier to grab.
This is where you got your USB plugins and your voltage power-ons.
Yep. So you only have one 12-volt outlet?
Right here, yeah. There's more in the back.
Oh, okay. Because for me, as a YouTuber, I I need to charge my camera equipment, like my drone, yep. My camera. So have another 12 volt will be beneficial to me. Oh no, your car do not have bioweapon defense mode.
Nah, you have to get the pup for that.
Pup? Oh yeah.
The performance upgrade stuff.
Yeah.
No problem. Performance upgrade package.
Yeah.
Yeah. The only thing in the pup that I would want is biodefense, and it wasn't worth the extra $5,000 for it.
Yes. And that's what I want. Put my YouTube channel on. Okay, this is my YouTube channel. I have some of the contents on it. If you like it, please give me a subscribe. And give me a like and a subscribe. And share it with your friends.
Yeah.
And I think your car is more fancy than that one. And it's not, and that one is noisy. Ooh. Ooh. Will sleep. Oh, 60. Be careful. You just throw all the cars behind. Ooh.